Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. How the code is actually formatted visually on our page can be important in terms of the readability of our code. It can make it easier for us to read our code and others to read our code. Black is a popular Python code formatter. We'll see the tool in action shortly, but essentially it's going to automatically format our code on the page and throughout our project, creating a consistently formatted code base. There are many different ways for us to configure Visual Studio Code and tools connected to it. So we've already seen that by going into code at the top here in the menu, going on to preferences and settings, we can change the settings of our Visual Studio Code experience. And that's one way of working. Now, one of the problems with doing that is you're setting kind of global settings. And you may be someone who is developing in different programming languages, in which case you want to use different tools for different languages. So sometimes you want to work project by project, in which case you want a more flexible, potentially, way of working to ensure that you can move from project to project, potentially, without having to reconfigure Visual Studio Code every time you do that. So let's first of all install Black. Now, there are two ways now of installing Black. You will find that it is an extension now. So if you type in Black here, Microsoft have now only recently made it an official Microsoft extension. Python Black here, Black formatter here, and by Microsoft. So that's one way of installing it. And I'm not making a recommendation here, but I prefer to pip install Black from the PyPI repository and then manage it manually. So now we've installed Black. If I were to, for example, let's go into, I don't think we've got anything here. Well, let's go into the settings here, right? So let's just remove some of these settings here. So I've just changed the formatting of it. So I've put lots of spaces in between here. So just before we run Black, let's set it up. So we're going to set up here a new folder in our project. And we're going to call that .vscode. So inside of here, we're going to add settings to configure our workstation manually. So inside of here, we'll create a new file called settings.json. And now we can go ahead and configure our workstation to utilize Black. So to do that, we need to add a little bit of code here. So this is a JSON file. So we'll open up with the curly braces and a few different settings. Now I'm just going to paste these in just for save a little bit of time here, and we can just discuss them. So let me zoom out a little bit. There we go. So first of all, we change the editor format on save to true. So what we want to do is whenever we save our file, we want to run our formatter. So that seems like a good idea. And then we describe our formatter. Now we are describing this specifically for Python. So in the Visual Studio Code setting here, we are setting this specifically for Python, and that would go and be the same for different programming languages. So we can actually set up different formatters and tools for different languages in this way. So formatting.provider, that's going to be Black. And then what we can do is we can add some arguments. Now, there isn't too much we can change here in Black, but just give you an idea. Of course, you can go to the documentation of Black if you're interested in learning a little bit more on the changes that you can make here. But ultimately, Black will be formatting our code following most of the PEP 8 guidelines, which is a stylistic guideline for Python, which you can have a look at. So if you type in PEP 8, that will give you some more information if you haven't already seen that before. So with that set, we are then configured, and we're telling VS Code to use Black and then to run Black whenever we save. Now, in our case, we want to also make sure that we're formatting all of these imports here. And this is why I kind of spaced them out so we can see the Black, so we can see Black in action. So inside of our settings, we're going to add an additional setting here, and that will get everything running nicely. So underneath here, I'm going to add a few more lines. So editor.code action on save. and we're going to source.organizeInputs. We could also add this into this section here, but let's give that a go. So, So with that code in place, now you will find that in the repository. And I'll place this code in a file here. I'll add a new file and I'll call this vscode.md. So it will only be available in the first section here. So you won't find in the repository this code here in the code example. So we'll see that in a minute. We're going to remove that from our source control. So I'll just add this in, and you'll find that in the repository if you download that from this section's code source. There we go. Okay, so with that in place, what we need to do now is we need to make sure that we're utilizing Python from the correct place. So down the bottom here, we can see that if I click here, we can see that we're using the interpreter from our event folder. That might not be the case in your case. So we just need to make sure that we're using the Python interpreter from our virtual environment. So we could just use the one that's on the computer that's installed globally, this global one here. But we want to make sure we're using that because black is installed in our virtual environment. So it's going to be looking for that and black in our virtual environment. And that's important. So with that in place, let's go ahead and just save this. And you can see that it automatically changes. As soon as I press save there, and you can see that everything is nicely formatted up top here, as well as other things in our code. There'll be more examples as we work along, but black is now started. It's working. Anytime we add any code and press save, you can see it automatically formats it for me. I have included a deeper explanation of black, and you'll find that in the optional section at the end of this course in the formatting optional section. So take a look at that if you're interested in learning a little bit more.